No swing.
Reach all the way through 10. Keep these straight. Yes. Reach it this way. Beautiful work. So here, you just raise them up by that 20. And then tighten them up.
Hand up here.
There you go.
This is Marlon, much harder than just sit-ups. You're going to have a 12-pack.
And with the rotations, keep your hips still. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're just marching in now 3 times. Yeah. 3. Is this funny?
Fun. 3. I'm doing that 3 times alone.
3 times alone like that. 1 more. 4. 2.
What is this for, Marlon?
3. And then in and out 5. This is an anti-rotation. So it helps keep your trunk stable. And then at the end, once you start rotating like this, that's your obliques.
You got it.
Don't rotate.
Good for those hooks.
You gotta drop your shoulders down too. And chest up. So one thing rotating is your trunk. Your hips are stuck in mud or cement. There you go.
So more arms. More obliques.
Yeah. But if you're feeling your arms, drop these down and tighten your lats. Yeah. Because the biggest thing is when you're marching out, your core is what's stopping. It's what's stopping the feet from going back. So just tense up this shit right here. So keep your fish right on you. Baby steps 3. Yeah. It's like you're about to get a body shot. Just keep it tight. Big breath in. Exhale. Go. 1, 2, 1, 3. Breath in, exhale. Go. Three, two, one. Good shit. Three, two, one, go. Two, one.
Marlon, tell people your Instagram one more time.
Marlon, MARLON.IAM.
And you're not Kel Brook, you're Marlon.
Switch. Yeah. Switch. Big breath in.
He looks just like him. He might fight Crawford next.
Go. Six. Five. Fast. Three. Two. One. Three.
Marlon the Magician. You never heard that one before.
I like that,
you could tell a difference when you work with him and you
can. Definitely, definitely.
You feel stronger.
I'm ready to full camp with Marlon.
Uh-huh.
Full camp is sparring. I'm ready to go.
Marlon, you gonna be in this area?
You're gonna try to steal the show on the Teofimo Lopez Lomachenko fight?
Whatever show I'm on, I'm trying to steal it.
That's a big fight.
Yeah, I'm really excited to get on it, you know? Big show.
We live in a crazy day and time where they have to have replacements for the main event standing by. Just because of reality. Happened to you?
Happened to me. Right. With the conditioning and then core and then some recovery breathing. But first, so we got band punches. This is with that, the breath hold, right? So you're going big breath in, exhale. Don't breathe, just as fast as you can, 6 seconds. As soon as you finish, in through your nose. And then you're gonna switch to the ball, ball slams. That one you can breathe throughout, but nose only, right? After that, 40 seconds of shadow boxing. Okay? So it's 40 seconds shadow boxing. Okay?
Why no breathing, Marlon?
That we're working on. Your oxygen efficiency. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. You're basically making them train hypoxically, so without oxygen. And as soon as they start breathing again, now the body uses the oxygen more efficiently. Let's stop.
Shit makes any little workout fucking hard.
Hey, what did Muhammad Ali say? He hated every morning a training, but he loved being a champion. I'm paraphrasing how he said it.
Two, one, go. Fast. Switch. Good shit. Three, two, one, go. Fast. Three, two, one, breathe. Nice and relaxed. Nice and relaxed. A really good book is called The Oxygen Advantage. I think every athlete should read it, but it's basically about hypoxic training and how it helps the body.
The blood cells, all that.
Yeah. Three. Four. Five. Good. Last one. Let's go.
This. Now they're working on speed strength. Coach Marlin over here. Adam Lopez in check.
We got five swings. Here, this is, you're gonna throw it up, I'm gonna catch it, and then I'm gonna rehand it. Right? So from this dead stop, you throw it up. But you can let it go. I'll catch it and hand it right back to you.
Yep.
You can start. Set that. Okay. Five each.
Five each side.
Fingers up. Yep. Chest up.
Is that hard?
Not too hard. You feel it in your legs though, for sure. After a few of them, they're gonna hurt.
You're gonna have legs like Mike Tyson.
No, I'm still saying it.
Those are tree trunks. Not bad as a southpaw.
I thought southpaw before. Buddy don't like me switching too much.
Why?
I don't know. There you go. I talked him into it, letting him practice a little more. We're gonna show them some fights.
You're gonna be like Crawford.
Adam's a beast in southpaw.
He's gonna be like Crawford. He's gonna be like Terrence Crawford.
Nah, he's better than Terrence Crawford. Not like Terrence Crawford. Better.
Gary Russell wants to fight Crawford.
I know, we were talking about that. It's a big task.
He's serious.
He believes in his work. It looks very hard.
This is the first time I've seen two fighters train with their watches on. I've never seen that in my life.
The heart rate monitor.
And he has the same one too?
Do it like that, so don't switch your stance, just like that. Okay, ready? Go.
I could tell you played soccer.
I didn't really play soccer.
That's how you take the ball out from out of bounds.
Yeah, I mean, I did like a year of soccer, but wasn't too big on it.
No.
So this guy helped me get ready for the belt this fight. Probably took for 2 weeks and that was it.
Hey, did you see what a good teammate Canelo is? He bought Oscar Valdez an extremely expensive horse.
I saw that.
They're crazy expensive.
Good.
Yeah? Generous. Not every superstar is like that.
Mm-hmm.
But Oscar's a good dude.
Yeah, he is. I got nothing to hate against him.
Listen, you fight people. It's your job. It's his job. It's business.
Exactly.
He should be good enough to give us a rematch, though.
Well, I think he's fighting Burchett next at 130. No?
He shouldn't.
Well, I think he could beat him.
You think so?
Yeah.
I mean, I heard him. I'm not a big puncher.
But different fights, different styles.
Yeah.
You're gonna have calves like Pacquiao in no time. Pedraza or Javier Molina?
Pedraza.
I don't know. I think Molina. What?
Yeah.
He's game.
At 140? Pedraza's at 140.
Huh? Yeah.
We're going back to the first time.
He's the last dude of the East LA style of boxing.
Maywood.
I grew up.
No, Molina can fight.
No, absolutely.
He just had a few setbacks over the years, injuries and other things, but he was on Team USA to the Olympics.
Yeah.
He was US.
Him and his brother.
Yeah, Oscar.
Yeah.
How's it going? Marlon, are they supposed to be sore tomorrow?
Sometimes. Usually, are you sore usually after every session?
The first few sessions, yeah.
And then it's normal. It's everything.
No, then it just depends what he wants to work on that day. If it's something we don't really do,
yeah, it'll get
and if the recovery is not on it,
do you do a cryo? Do you believe in cryotherapy or ice bath? Does it work? Do you believe in it?
Not immediately after, like right away.
Yeah.
I like sauna too. Sauna's what we get.
Two?
Yeah.
How? He helps you make weight too?
He gives me diet tips. Yeah, he knows a lot about nutrition. But I've never really had a hard time making weight, so I kind of know what
you're lucky.
Yeah, I know my body.
You want a lucky one.
I keep it in check in between. Like right now, I got like maybe 6 weeks, and I'm already bringing it down. So when it's time for making weight, it'll be easy.
You stay ready, so you don't have to get ready. That's like circus shit.
Yeah, a little circusy here.
Yeah. Hey, you're doing so good till we jinxed it. What's that one? Rub your stomach and your head at the same time?
Can you do that?
No. Can you do this drill with the weight?
Do what?
Do it with the weight. 10 pound weight.
Yeah.
I'm joking. Like, you know, you slam the ball.
Yeah.
Like the beer can challenge.
Oh.
Where you throw it on the floor and it ricochets.
I don't think so.
Let's go lower body now. So we're going to go here. One leg.
Manny Pacquiao does that. Come on, check.
Yeah, back around on the left. Go back on the left. Oh, no, sorry. You finish, come around, and then hit the left side.
Good job.
We got 3 rounds.
That ball needs a cup, man. He needs to get some stitches. Not easy. Equipment fall apart.
Yeah.
So you're kind of driving and sitting. Straighten your body in the air. Yeah.
It looks hard.
That one fucking hurts, I ain't gonna lie. You're doing a squat like on one leg, basically.
But you keep a poker face, it looks like it's easy. Check, are you Filipino?
No.
Puerto Rican?
Mexican.
In Miami, in Florida?
Yeah.
Not a lot of Mexicans there, huh? Marlon,
yeah.
What would you tell some trainers, old school trainers, don't believe in strength and conditioning. What would you tell them?
I say let a fighter try it, feel the difference, and then they notice a difference in sparring. Because it also depends on the coach, how the coach works. 5 seconds. 4.
Back to the same thing?
Yeah. 3. 2, last one here. Go.
Okay, first of all, introduce yourself really quick to everybody watching.
What's up, everybody? Marlon.
Where do they follow you, Marlon, on Instagram?
Marlon.im.
And who's with us today, Marlon?
We got Adam.
Adam Blue Nose Lopez.
Uh-huh. And we got Check here.
Check is very talented. I heard he's very powerful. He's from Florida, right? Florida?
Yes. Yeah.
Czech Republic.
Melbourne.
Checkmate.
Check here, like
Check. Check, are you professional yet?
Yeah.
What's your record?
2-1.
That's badass. All right, keep it going. So, really quick, what are you working on today?
We're doing a lot of explosive stuff, mainly explosive power. And then we got some speed, strength.
And how
keeping
does this,
them explosive.
How does this help them as fighters, as boxers?
So, what we're doing here is we're really just trying to keep their bodies healthy and perform optimally. And what we're doing here is we're warming up the lower body so they can do the explosive power movements.
All right, so we can expect Adam Lopez to have a major knockout when he fights October 17 on the undercard of Teofimo Lomachenko. Ivan, are you joining the workout today?
I will be soon. He's going to start teaching little classes here. I'm going to start joining in, but not today.
Okay.
I let the guys do the thing on their own.
It's okay. It's training conditioning.
Yeah.
It's not easy. I can say that much.
Turn on the second one. Yeah. Turn on the second one. So it's one hop, then turn. There. Just hop on the second one. Turn on the second one.
Do you make up your, you come up with your own drills?
Yeah.
All original stuff. You're not going to see this anywhere else.
Well, I mean, really, there's not much that you can create. Everything is already there.
Mm-hmm.
I like to just work on the fundamentals. 5. So right here, a lot of times when you're punching and you're trying to be explosive, a lot of it comes from the hips.
True.
So we're trying to warm up the hips to make it more explosive.
Is it hard?
It's just weird. It's a weird rhythm.
Different. Yeah. Different. But it's going to make you better as a fighter.
Wakes your hips up. He knows what he's doing.
Here we're going to do a jump slam. Okay. Right up. Let's see what the hips. Does it matter
if I'm? No, you
don't. Down broke his CS here. 2 days ago.
What happened?
Oh, John Beck broke.
He's too strong. He's a beast. Buddy tells me he beats anyone at 160. So these are 10-pound weights?
10-pound weights. So here's the back. You're going to jump up, straighten your body at the top, and then you're going to slide it down even before once you get to that top. Once you feel that stretch, snap it right now.
You jumped it, right?
Yeah.
I bet your hands feel super light right now.
Yeah. Pretty light. I mean, I worked out earlier, so I'll wake up for this one.
Adam, how did you guys link up?
Who's that? Me and Marlon? I've known Marlon since I was about 15, 16 years old.
Pullman's, I think you met?
Yeah, Pullman's gym. You used to train with John, right?
Yeah.
So, he used to train with John. I used to train at John's gym. He recently started getting his strength and conditioning, so we just linked up. Been working together for last few years.
It's working.
Oh, around the world?
Around the world,
yeah.
5 for 5?
5, yep.